And finally tonight, our visit to Boston today. I spent time here as a reporter, back today visiting the team at WCVB. But we don't come for a visit without finding something made in America. So tonight, the American workers who would be very proud to fit you.
Our Made in America team all across New England. Remember L.L. Bean and their signature boots? All made in Brunswick, Maine. And the team behind Randolph sunglasses just outside Boston's.
Way to go.
We tried them on, realizing we were better off leaving it to them. And tonight, our stop in New Bedford, Massachusetts. The sign right outside, they're hiring. Inside the factory coming to life, just as it has now for three decades. 800 workers cut and sew more than 1,000 men's suits every day for the brand Joseph Abboud. And we went to find the man behind it.
What a success story after all these years.
You know, that's a form of survival, isn't it? You know, 30 years.
For 30 years, Abboud suits have been made in America. The New Bedford factory just 30 miles from where he grew up and from where we discovered his high school voted him best dressed.
We look back at your high school yearbook.
Oh, yes. Okay, thank you for doing that.
It's pretty prophetic, right?
That's amazing.
Best dressed.
Best dressed. It was, you know, I always thought that dressing well opened doors.
And it did. And after years of success, he sold his business, his trademark, but had to say goodbye to his employees. Later, he began working with Men's Warehouse.
You left. You never thought you would work with your name again.
I never knew if I would. Yeah, I didn't know.
That's the incredible thing.
Yeah.
Because it would turn out the owner of Men's Warehouse would buy Abboud's trademark back, reuniting the man with his brand and his American workers.
When I walked back into that factory for the first time, it was a pretty emotional moment because all the people came up and embraced me. It was like coming home again.
Right at home here, where Abboud says the people are the fabric of his success.
We're very proud of that history because Joseph is an American designer, and we have an American factory and an American workforce.
And the workers here can spot their suits on the street.
I feel proud. I feel proud of the people that I work with. It's a good feeling.
Stitched together, those three words.
Made in America and making America look good at the office. We leave you tonight from historic Quincy Market, built back in the 1820s. I'll see you back from New York tomorrow night. I'm David Muir from all of us here. Good night.